Let's run it. Revelation chapter 7, verse 14, straight to the point. Get back to the
top. And I said unto him,
Hey,
how you doing?
Hey, what does this mean to you?
Read something very quick. Tell me what this means to you. Revelation 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. Meaning, pay attention, pay heed, right? He that leadeth in captivity should go into captivity. What does that mean?
Leadeth into captivity?
Slavery.
Oh, here's my take on slavery. Can I?
Yeah, you can, but break this down for me real quick. He that leadeth in captivity shall go into captivity.
You can't just read a verse. You have to read the context.
It doesn't.
The whole context. What do you want me to read?
Verse means something.
You want me to read all Revelation
13?
It doesn't matter what the context is, and this is the context. He that have it, let him hear.
I don't agree with slavery, but you have to read the context of
he that leadeth into captivity should go into captivity. He's talking about captivity. So he that leadeth captivity should go into captivity. Read the context. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. So the captivity, the context is, this is the patience and the faith of the saints. The Lord's saints will have patience that whoever led them in captivity should go into captivity. Whoever killed them with the sword should be killed with the sword. And they actually have faith that this is going to happen.
There is no slavery anymore. Slavery is not real.
This is Revelation chapter 13.
That's what we said.
But you all read it. Every person has to watch what they do.
Okay.
It doesn't matter.
So you said there's no slavery anymore, right?
Huh?
Right. So red letter in the Bible means what? It's coming from the Lord. They call Jesus Christ, right? Revelations 2, verse 25. But that which ye have already hold fast till I come. The faith, the truth, right? Hold your faith until I come. We just read faith of the saints, right? In Revelation 13, verse 26. He that overcometh, you overcometh to the end, till the Lord returns, right?
Yeah.
And keepeth my works. Who is the mind? Who they call Jesus Christ, right? The Lord. Keeping my works.
Your acts.
So are you keeping, so the question is, well, let's move past that. My works until the end. So you got to keep Jesus Christ's works until the end, till he comes, right? This is his works. It says, to him will I give power over nations. What does it mean? What does it mean to give power over a nation?
Well, power. You can have power in heaven. So focus more on what power you're gonna have once you go to heaven.
I'm happy you said that. You know why? Because the next verse gives you more detail and more context. Let's see if you're right or if the Bible's right. Verse 27. He shall rule them with a rod of iron. So we're gonna rule over other nations in the kingdom in heaven with a rod of iron. So we're going to be up in the sky ruling over other nations. You know that's bullshit. We're going to be here on earth, and this is red letter.
We're talking about two separate things.
Yeah, but you're not talking about what I'm talking about. I'm trying to get you to talk about this verse. Are you talking about this verse?
Where are you guys coming from? What are you guys trying to get?
I'm finna read it.
What are you guys trying to get the truth?
I'm finna read it right now. Just trying to get the truth. We're trying to see if a regular man could walk by and hear the truth of the Bible, and will he take it for what it is, or will he make
up? I'm a Christian. I go to West.
But you're an average man.
Scripture.
Let me deal with it. You're an average man, right?
I'm an average man.
You're a Christian, right?
Yeah.
So you follow the Bible, the whole Bible, the whole road, right?
Not always.
So you don't follow the whole Bible. So you're really not a real Christian. Because the Lord said you come in the volume of the book.
Do you follow it perfectly?
Yep. We lost statutes, commandments. You fringes. Yep. We follow all the high and holy days. We follow all the lost statutes, commandments. Run out my beard. No hairline.
No murder, no stealing.
Deal with your brother. Love your brother. Everything. You think we out here playing? We don't follow off
this. What's your take on dealing drugs? Where does it say in the Bible that you're not supposed to alter people's minds?
I don't want to go off into a rabbit hole, but dealing what drugs? Just because America says something illegal don't mean the Lord says it's illegal.
Exactly.
But where he's getting at is he's trying to do is single out, you know what I'm saying? So he brought up the
nobody's trying to keep people captive.
Listen.
But you gotta there's police for a reason. You know?
There's just, did the Romans have police? Were they a wicked nation? Were they destroyed? Yes. Did the Egyptians have masters and captains? Were they a wicked nation? Were they destroyed? Yes. So that don't mean
not all police officers are
listen.
Wicked.
The Lord told us what to be doing. They not doing what the Lord told us to do. Did the Lord say go out and police people? Go out and put people in handcuffs and take them to jail? Did the Lord say he gonna get judgment? So why are they getting judgment?
Follow the laws of your land. Have you read that?
Yeah, now you wanna talk about context. Well, during that time, was they talking about America? Were they in America talking about follow the laws of America? The laws of the land were when they are in Israel. That's what the context of that. Follow the laws of the land, which is the law, statutes, commandments.
You don't believe in laws here in America?
The laws here in America are wicked. Why would the Lord come back and destroy this place?
Don't be of a sober mind. So when we take somebody to jail for we take somebody to jail for selling drugs.
This is easy. What? This is clearly. You can answer yourself. Is the Lord coming back with wrath and destruction?
He will if you do the wrong thing.
So why is the Lord coming back, period, on earth with wrath and destruction?
He is, not will. Let me go.
Is the Lord coming back, period, with wrath and destruction? Does the Bible say the Lord is coming back with wrath and destruction?
Today, yes.
Whenever he comes back. Yeah, so if this place is righteous, why do we need to come back with wrath and destruction? Because it's wicked. It's that simple.
You can't legalize gay marriage.
Break this out. Exactly. I agree with you. No, that's right. Shalom. Now, but look. It says, he shall rule them with a rod of iron. This is red letter. It's coming directly from Jesus Christ, and it's in the Bible, Revelation. Not my words. I'm not making it up. It says, as a vessel of potter, they should be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. He received this power of his Father. He says he's going to give it to them that overcometh and keep his words to the end to do this. To do what? He that overcometh and keepeth my words to the end, to him will I give power over the nations. He shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessel of potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. In the kingdom of heaven will there be slavery. Taking that verse.
There will not be slavery, but there's no slavery.
Read it again.
There's no slavery.
Read it again. He that overcometh and keepeth my words to the end, to him will I give power over the nations. Meaning the Lord's going to come back and give people power over other nations. He's going to set up his kingdom. It says, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
Everybody's watched by police. It's not.
What does he? What does he shall rule them with a rod of iron mean?
Huh?
What does he shall rule them with a rod of iron? Is that slavery? Ruling somebody with a rod of iron? Think about it. Is that slavery?
From your origin.
Your problem is you think when the Lord has come back that America's going to still be here. America's not going to be. America's going to be destroyed when the Lord comes. But do I got to prove it to you here? I'll prove it to you. I'm not just going to go off my words.
That's what the church is teaching.
I'll prove it to you. You think that America law and everything about America, America's going to be destroyed. America's going to fight against the Lord. Do you know who's going to fight against the Lord when he comes back? It says the armies of the earth.
The people that follow the Antichrist. You know what the Antichrist is?
There's many Antichrists. Anything that goes against the Lord is Antichrist.
But you know,
the Lord is Christ.
The Antichrist. You know what the mark of the beast is?
Yes, do you?
Yeah, I know.
That's a good question. No, you don't. Tell me, what is it?
It means when you accept the devil.
Nope.
He will give you the mark of the beast.
The mark of the beast is talking about an implant chip. Their whole new world order, digital everything. That's why you have Bitcoin. The whole new world order is to make everything digital.
They talk about the mark of the beast being planted on your forehead.
Yeah. Have you heard Elon Musk narrow chip?
They're not going to put a chip in your forehead.
Look up Elon Musk narrow chip.
Okay.
And tell me if it's going in your forehead or not. He's literally putting it in your forehead. You want to know what it does? It hooks you up to the internet. So anywhere you go, you have the thoughts of the internet in your mind. You can Google anything in your mind. You have a chip in your head. And matter of fact, we're going to go to that. Hold that. This is Revelation 2,
That'll
verse 44.
Take care of criminals.
It says, in the day of these kings should the God of heaven set up a kingdom. So this is kingdom of heaven, right? You agree. In the days of these kings, should the God of heaven set up a kingdom. When the Lord sets up a kingdom, that's going to be the kingdom of heaven, right? We agree. You're a Christian, right?
Okay.
It says, we should never be destroyed. Of course, the kingdom of heaven is never going to be destroyed. You agree, right? You're a Christian. Okay. It says, and the kingdom should not be left to other people, meaning it's only for his people, the Israelites. Let's move past that. It says, but should break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, right? This is good for you. You should learn this. and shall stand forever. So what does break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms mean? When he sets up his kingdom, that mean that every other kingdom on earth, America, China, Russia, is going to be broken in pieces, and there's only going to be the kingdom of heaven. Now, you understand, being a Christian, there's not going to be a kingdom of heaven, and then America's going to be over here doing their thing. China's going to be over here doing their thing. Russia's going to be over here doing their thing. You understand when the Lord comes back and set up a kingdom, that's going to be the one.
Do you know what judgment day is for your own personal transactions?
It, literally what you just said. It's judgment day. The Lord's coming to set judgment day.
You know what sexual immorality is? That's a big problem.
You tell me what you think sexual immorality is. Well, because going back to the laws is a lot different.
You know, sexual immorality when you date multiple women at the same time, that's sexual immorality.
No, it's not. I'll prove it to you. Exodus. You want me to prove it to you? Now, when I prove this to you, right? Are you gonna take what the word of the Bible says? Or are you going to take what you was taught?
That's Old Testament.
And believe.
It says take a wife, not take multiple wives or have.
Let me break it down. Sex is marriage.
Yeah, I know, but you're not supposed to have sex before you're married.
Sex is marriage. There's no such thing. You have sex with a woman, according to the Lord, it's marriage. How did the Native Americans get married? Did they go get an American certificate?
The Native Americans didn't worship God.
How did they get married? Did they have wives?
They worshiped.
Can you as a man sit here in my face and tell me the Native American men didn't have wives? I know Native American men. Did they get American certificates? No, because America wasn't even formed yet. So how did they marry? Sex. When you have sex with a woman, she's supposed to be your wife. Didn't Isaac take Rebecca, if I'm getting it right, Rebecca into his mother's tent, and she became his wife? Did they have a ceremony?
Is that Old Testament?
Yes, but why is the Old Testament here? We
not the New
far.
Testament washes out.
No.
You gotta read the New Testament.
And I'm finna break that down to you. Get John 5. I'm finna break that down to you, but I wanna finish this. If he take him another wife, woo, he got one wife, he took another wife. It says, her food, her remnant, and her duty of marriage should not be diminished. Another one. Deuteronomy 21, precept upon precept. And then I wanna go back to the mark of the beast, because that's very interesting, you know? That's a very, very interesting topic.
And when he says something about the Old Testament.
That's the end.
And when he says something about the Old Testament.
Yeah, we're going to get to
I just want to say something real quick. When he says something about the Old Testament, but when the Lord, who they call Jesus Christ, was preaching the word, he was preaching the Old Testament.
Yeah,
he said. There wasn't no such thing as the New Testament.
He got you on that. You cut. Because the Lord literally said, bring me the book of Isaiah.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? He was preaching the Old Testament.
What I said was
you're supposed to wash out. You can't wash out the entire Old Testament.
Oh, now you're switching it up. No, you didn't say that. The Lord, listen,
said that's
you're a Christian
Testament.
Man. I could prove it to you. Luke 4:17. The Lord said, bring me the book of Isaiah. He opened the book and he read. Meaning he was going off the Old Testament. But let me go through this because I don't want him to get away. Revelation 21, verse 15. If a man have two wives, one be loved and another hated. If a man have two wives, this is in our law. The law, statute, commandments given to Moses, given to the Israelites. It's very simple. If a man have two wives, we can hold it there. Get John 5, verse 46. Let me stop at Matthew chapter 5, right, real quick for the brother. Since he's learning. And it's okay. You ain't got to be prideful. You know, you thought one thing, you learned one thing, you came to me, I'm showing you precepts, take it, and then you go teach. So when somebody comes to you saying this and that, then you could be like, nope, it says this, it says that.
Yeah.
But are you listening to the things that I'm reading? Am I making these things up already in the Bible? I'm just reading them, right? So look, this is going to cut everything you said, though. This is very hard on you, bro. I feel sad for you. This is Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Think that, this is coming from the Lord directly, Jesus Christ. Think not that I have come to destroy the law. Or the prophets, I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. He had to fulfill the prophecies of homecoming and everything he had come to. But he said, think not that I come to destroy the law. Even more.
You got to be careful misleading them.
Even more. Nope, because you're going to say that it means something else, but it tells you what it means. The next verse. It says, for verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, heavens, the skies, earth, the ground, right? To heaven or earth pass, One jot or one twiddle shall in no wise pass from the law. Not one jot, not one twiddle. Even if a man has two wives, if he take him another wife, you can't take a wife and then the duty and the marriage and everything you was doing for your previous wife, the first wife, you start to not do that. You still have to be a husband to her and a husband to your next wife. King David had multiple wives. King Solomon had multiple wives. Oh, but they were kings. Okay, well, Jacob had multiple wives. How do you think the 12 tribes of Israel got here? He had multiple wives. Abraham had multiple wives. Hagar, Sarah. Many men in the Bible have multiple wives. The Lord told King David personally, I gave you your master's wives. And if you had wanted more, I would have gave you more wives. The Lord said, look, man gonna lose wives, children, but in the kingdom, this is Matthew chapter 19, I should give you 100-fold. If you lose a wife on this side,
I don't agree with having multiple wives.
Well, you don't agree with
that. But it's not for him.
So guess what? No, I got him. Yeah, so guess what? Guess what that make you? Make you an Antichrist. Because that's Christ. Then he say, who's the word?
Yeah.
Who's the word? Yeah, oh, look, on that, he got to go.
No, on that, right? I'm not an answer.
Okay, come back. Okay, I apologize. Come back and talk to me like a man. He got to run. That cut you. You are Antichrist because you say you don't agree with multiple wives. And the Lord, it's lawful for us to have multiple wives. So you're going to go against the Lord. Now, if he's saying personally, like, I don't want to have multiple wives personally, that's your choice. Yeah. But when you say, I don't agree with having multiple wives.
Pretty much saying people that do is sinning.
Is sinning, then that makes you an Antichrist. Walk off. We do this for Yasharallah, man. It's that word. He cut. He tried. He got cut so many times, man. He tried so hard. We're going to finish cutting him. You know? He had to walk off. It says, and no wise passed from the law to all be fulfilled. I mean, the law is still here, and it even goes into more context to prove that the law is still here. Whoever so therefore should break one of these least commandments. So if you even break these commandments, right, and should teach man so like he is teaching, you ain't got to keep the commandments because that's what he was getting to. It says, shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whosoever should do and teach them, the same should be called great in the kingdom of heaven. So we got to do these commandments and keep them and teach them. Get that. John 5, I think verse 46. Cutting them.
For had ye believed Moses, ye would have believed me.
Stop right there. Where is Moses' writings found at?
First five books of the
Which is Old Testament.
Old Testament.
So like he was saying, you got to wash out the Old Testament. Well, Moses' writings is found in the Old Testament. What did the Lord say? Read it again.
For had ye believed Moses, ye would have believed me. For he wrote of me. But if ye believe not his writings, how shall ye believe my word?
Woo! He said, look, if you ain't believe Moses' writings, you don't believe the Old Testament, how you gonna believe in me? Because he wrote of me. So how you gonna believe in me if you don't believe Moses? And Salaki, I was just trying to deal with it, bro.
No,
I didn't want him to escape.
Yeah, I feel
you. See what I'm saying? If you get
it was a certain thing.